And actually, if you see right here, $393 billion was wiped from China's benchmark, yung Shanghai Index. Almost 8% ang nawala sa kanya. So,
hello everyone and welcome to this very special video. And with me today is si Jeff Guo from eToro. Hello, Jeff.
Hi. Hi, Fitz. Hi. Hi, everyone. I hope everybody's still healthy.
Si Jeff is in Hong Kong, no? So, nako, ingat tayo dyan, Jeff.
Oo nga, medyo marami-rami ng cases. Recently, kahapon, may nag-pass away na din. But so far, it's been a bit okay. Not as bad as China.
So we wish you safety there. And to those who are wondering, sino ba tong si Jeff? Jeff, can you say a little bit something about yourself and also a background on the company that you work for, which is eToro?
Okay, perfect. So just very briefly, 1 minute pitch ko sa sarili ko. I'm Jeff. I'm the Business Development Associate for eToro for the Philippines. So basically, mabilis na naman, my job lang is to help our Philippine clients or our Filipinos with eToro and also to help grow the brand in the Philippines. If hindi pa tayo familiar, eToro is, I'm sure mas alam niyo yung ads kesa sa amin. Marami kaming ads over YouTube. I'm sure nakita niyo na si Steve and Dave. But basically, eToro is the world's largest social trading platform. What that means is that you can trade and invest in different assets, stocks, crypto, gold and oil, forex, sa eToro, but with a social twist. So something like Facebook for investing. Parang ganun.
Oo, bale. Instead of spending time sa Facebook na nakikipag-away ka, they can definitely open an account with eToro, check out the social trading platform, and interact with people all over the world, no, who trade and invest in different asset classes. And of course, we will give you guys a link where you can sign up for eToro and you can open a virtual account. Practice account, no, para makita nyo yung platform. And one of the things that I like about eToro, especially my followers, they know that I've been really raving about eToro, is it's a multi-asset broker, no? Ibig sabihin, you're not limited to the Philippines anymore. You can actually trade and invest sa mga iba't ibang klaseng asset classes, including mga index funds, currencies, cryptocurrencies, yung mga mahilig sa mga Bitcoin, yan, pwede sa eToro. And one of my favorite parts sa eToro is access sa mga US stocks,
equities,
no?
Yes.
Yes, equities, especially last year in 2019, yung US equities really performed very well. Mm-hmm. May mga companies na talagang
blow up.
Kumita ka ng malaki kung nakapag invest ka doon, all right? So for today, that's the reason why I invited Jeff for this video. Is because merong i-share si Jeff sa inyo. Ano ba yung gusto mong i-share sa kanila, Jeff?
So basically, yun nga, yung in-approach ako ni Fitz for the interview. Basically, my idea was I wanted to touch on, of course, the global markets. Ano bang pwede mong gawin sa eToro? Ano bang maipapahagi namin sa inyo? But also, with all of the news about coronavirus, all of these health-related stuff, epidemics, rightly so, marami mga taong medyo natatakot. Tama ba na pumasok sa markets ngayon? Ano bang mangyayari sa global markets with this big epidemic? So I'm going to touch on that as well as, for example, some stocks na pwede ninyong tignan. So first and foremost, we do not give trading advice, so this should not be considered trading advice. But we're merely pointing facts na ito yung mga nangyari. Ito yung mga pwede ninyong i-watch out for sa global markets this time around.
Yes, and hopefully the information that you will share will help them and guide them in their investing and trading decisions. Sure. So at least meron silang overview of what's currently happening and what we think could happen for the year. No? And are you going to give some sample companies na ano ba yung ano outlook nila?
Yes, so basically we have a few, actually saktong-sakto yung oras natin ngayon kasi just last week and even a few days now, nagre-release ng earnings yung mga companies to close out 2019. So magandang opportunity siya para makita natin kung sino yung mga okay.
Yan. Okay. So, sige, Jeff, I think you have a presentation that you want to share.
Yes. So just give me a moment to share my screen really quick.
Yes, okay.
There. So very quickly, basically it's February. Bilis din ang oras, 1 month na rin yung naglipas. So the main points that I really want to start with is coronavirus. again, maraming nagsasabi na I don't want to update too much on coronavirus. Every single day may mga new updates about it, a lot of canceled flights. But the main question for us as investors is ano bang nagagawa ng effects ng coronavirus epidemic na to to our economy. So first and foremost, of course, is we have to look at China. Kasi nga sa China siya nanggaling. So again, we're just gonna talk about the economy. I don't wanna talk too much on the politics, on the social aspects of it. But basically, if you look at China, di ba, I'm sure marami tayong jokes about this na everything is made in China. It's basically it's basically the world's manufacturing hub. So the world's largest factory, and of course, since manufacturing siya, maraming mga tao sa kanya, maraming mga aspects ng economy niya is related to manufacturing. And of course, kailangan mo ng workers for this. So imagine with all of these coronavirus, I think even in the Philippines, meron tayong once you get back, I think 14 days kang dapat nagka-quarantine. And it's even worse for China kasi diba kakalagpas lang nung Chinese New Year. So they're coming back from holidays. With this coronavirus, hindi natin alam kung yung mga workers, babalik ba sila sa factory nila? Pagkabalik nila sa factory nila, makakapagtrabaho ba kagad ulit sila? Right? Some of them might be sick. All of these things. Another thing is, so that's one part, yung manufacturing on the business side. But on the other side, so consumers, mapapansin mo rin, I think even in Hong Kong here, mapapansin mo, talagang bumawas yung mga tao sa public spaces. Maybe in the Philippines as well, it's also the same case, but especially in China. Right, so madaming mga consumers na natatakot pumunta sa public places or if ever may mask sila, wearing a lot of things. So what this means is that yung mga restaurants, for example, shopping malls, a lot of their revenues, of course, nanggagaling sa mga retail customers. Kung walang pumupunta sa mga restaurants, nobody is eating out, mahirap na siya. So it will affect both the consumer and obviously the factories as well. Tapos there's a possibility for it to snowball. So yun yung pinakakinakatakutan ng mga tao. And actually, if you see right here, $393 billion was wiped from China's benchmark, yung Shanghai Index. Almost 8% ang nawala sa kanya. Yes, but $393 billion was wiped out kasi nga people are afraid of what might happen. So you'll see on the chart here, sa eToro na chart natin, you can trade China A50. Makita mo nag-drop siya. But at the same time, obviously, na-predict din naman ng China to. Nagpasok ng $173 billion ang China sa kanilang economy to help at least mitigate the damage. So makita mo, I highlighted it here, yung green na candle dyan. On that day, I believe this was February 3, nag-bounce back a little bit yung ano, yung economy ng China or yung index nila because of the fuel in because of the fuel injection nga nung ano nung kanilang government. So I want to highlight Nasdaq here. Nasdaq is actually up 3.4% kahit na ano siya, kahit na part siya ng US na market. So which is a good segue to my next point. Bakit kaya, kasi actually yung nakita ko to, nagwonder din ako bakit kaya yung Nasdaq mismo ano siya, negative siya while the others were negative. Nasdaq was positive while the others were negative. If you really think about it, the main reason for this, I think, is because si Nasdaq mismo, pag tinignan mo yung list of companies niya, marami sa mga list of companies niya are software companies or tech companies. So, di ba, as we mentioned a while ago, karamihan kasi talaga sa China is manufacturing and labor intensive. So sila yung obviously mabilis makita na talaga maapektuhan sila ng coronavirus na to. But if your business is major based on software, for example, Amazon, For example, Alibaba as well, right? Mm-hmm. Hindi siya ganun ka-affected kasi nga software-based naman yung ano mo, yung business mo. So which is why I wanted to cover. Also, another thing, actually, before we go to the companies, I wanted to quickly show you guys lang. This is a very interesting index that I saw. What this means lang, medyo magulo yung chart niya, pero what this means lang is that itong MSCI World Index, ito yung ano, kinumpile niya lahat ng mga 23 indices from different countries and mm-hmm. anong nangyari sa kanya during the past epidemic. So makita mo, you guys can even pause your screen, makita mo ninyo yung measles, Ebola, Zika, SARS, H1N1, kung anong mga nangyari sa market after ng mga ano na to, ng mga epidemics na to. So for example, if you look at SARS, SARS is very interesting actually. 1 month after natapos yung ano, yung SARS na epidemic, 8% up na yung mga ano, yung economy ng global markets. Uh-huh. 3 months later, 16% na. 6 months later, 21% up na siya. So so SARS is, so basically what this tells us is, yes, kapag nasa epidemic ka, madaming mga ano, madaming mga doom and gloom like what we mentioned a while ago, madaming mga bad things that people are coming out about, but there is a resilient side to it na nagba-bounce back yung markets. So SARS is 21% after 6 months. So I'm looking at this one, yung 6 months dyan. Yes. SARS was 21%, H5N1 10%. Yung swine flu, I think this was also, I think naapektuhan din tayo nito eh.
Marami yan. Actually, based on the statistics, parang swine flu talaga yung pinakamalaking outbreak at din yung pinakamaraming casualties eh.
Malaki yun eh, kasi I think even sa atin, maraming nakal na pork and also maraming businesses na tumigil din for quite a long time. Uh-huh. But very interestingly to see na SARS was up 21%, pero yung swine flu, 6 months later, yung global market index, 39.96 up. So 40% up na rin siya. So kumbaga, not just bounce back to the normal level, pero talagang nag-bounce back even higher pa siya. And even the others, if you look at the other epidemics, this is going back to 1980s pa nga to eh. If you look at the other epidemics, yung iba sa kanila nag-bounce back ng a little bit, but even the ones that are negative, the biggest negative, for example, is I believe pneumonic plague, pero matagal na yan. We'll cover, for example, Ebola, minus 3.49% lang siya after 6 months. And if you look at it, CPSE right now, year to date, down 7% siya, 7.5%. Mm-hmm. So it's really a big difference. And it just goes to show na tayo, not just the US, not just China, not just UK, but the whole world, kasi ito buong mundo to eh. Whole world is able to bounce back from epidemics.
Yes, yes. That's very good news para sa mga long-term investors.
Right, right. Kasi ano naman eh, kumbaga kung long-term investor ka naman, obviously affected ka pa rin by the short-term movements. Pero if your outlook is long-term naman, then it shouldn't be too big of a problem. This should be very, very good news na nakakabawi yung mga markets.
Yes.
So basically what we want to highlight here is that yes, during this time, volatile yung mga periods. And the good thing with volatile periods, obviously what we always like to say is it presents opportunities as well. So kung very, very keen-eyed ka, kung mabantay ka talaga sa mga nangyayari every day, for example, for sure may makita kang mga buying opportunities dyan. Right? Kasi nga, bababa siya, baka you feel that this is a good time to enter the market, this is a good time to buy whatever asset you're looking at. So there is a short-term viability pa rin, even in volatile markets. And again, in long-term, nakakapag-bounce back naman yung markets. So nagsimula tayo sa doom and gloom. but what I wanted to end lang is that for this part at least, what I wanted to really drive home lang is that there is a big signs. There are signs now we're able to bounce back for this.
Yes.
So basically, in terms of software naman, the number one company that I really want to cover or I really want to mention to everybody is Amazon. Mm-hmm. Not just because of their earnings. Mamaya na natin pag-uusapan yun. Pero firstly, yung kung napansin ninyo, as we mentioned a while ago, maraming ang mga tao na nag-a-avoid ng public places lately. Mm-hmm. So anong ginagawa ng mga tao?
Right? They buy online.
Yes. Correct. So basically, this was true even for Alibaba, not just Amazon, but for example, Alibaba is a very big player. For example, JD as well. JD is Alibaba's competitor in China. So these are stocks to look out for as well. Both Alibaba and JD are available in eToro, by the way. So pwede nyo silang tignan. But we're not going to look into it. But on the topic, even not just online shopping, pag napansin ninyo, I'm sure a lot of us have done it already. Netflix is also one thing, mga entertainment. Yes. Disney, di ba? May mga Disney Plus na sila, ganun.
Yes.
So, marami talagang, if you really just sit down and think about it, ano ba yung mga ginagawa ko kapag hindi ako lumalabas? Right? And then most of these, may company na nag-offer ng service na yon. So, that might be something to look at. But Amazon, going back to Amazon, maganda yung naging performance niya. Back to 1 trillion market cap na si Amazon. Kasi nag-release sila ng earnings niya last week on, I believe it was Friday. What it means is that yung value ng buong company, 1 trillion na. So some companies that are similar to Amazon before na nakaabot ng 1 million is Apple, Google, as well as Saudi Aramco. Very big news siya. But all of these basically are same, roughly the same as Amazon, na 1 trillion yung worth ng buong company nila. So very, very big news. Which is why if you look at the chart, actually, pag tinignan mo, malaki yung tinalon ni Amazon. So before that, for the past few months, actually since the second half of the year, medyo lagging yung ano niya, stock prices niya, wala masyadong pinupuntahan. And then suddenly, paglabas ng earnings report niya last week, biglang tumalon. I believe it was from about 1,800 plus all the way up to 2,000. So basically, roughly 12% yung tinalon ng price niya. So it's not just, okay, umabot na tayong 1 trillion, very good, right? They're looking to invest more and grow the business even more, especially since available pa lang si Amazon in the US. I mean, available siya majority in the US, but other markets, hindi pa nila masyado nako-cover. So there's definitely, definitely room to grow as well. So that's Amazon. And in the topic of AWS, I think a lot of people are familiar with the word as well, especially kung office worker kayo. I myself, alam ko rin to, we actually, eToro actually uses it as well. We use Azure. So Azure is a competitor of AWS owned by Microsoft naman.
Yes, yes.
Right. So see, Microsoft also released earnings last week, same as Amazon. While Amazon, sobrang na-outbeat na yung expectations ng analysts, si Microsoft natalo niya rin, pero not as big. Revenues niya, $36.9 billion, 14% growth year-on-year compared to Amazon na 50%, 21% revenue. Sa kanya, 14% lang. But it's not so bad as well. Profit nila up 38% year-on-year. I think sobra to. But anyways, profit up nila 38% year-on-year. Again, the question for us is, saan ba talaga nanggaling yung growth ni Microsoft? The first thing is Microsoft Office. Is basically, they're very, very big cash cow sila for Microsoft Office. I think, kasi even now, ano eh, di ba before binibili mo yung license,
ngayon subscription na.
Subscription na siya ngayon. Dati bibili mo yung CD, ngayon wala nang CD.
Wala.
Online na lang siya. It's really just a subscription nowadays. And yung retail customer like you and me, 37 million na yung customers nila for this. It's 37 million but it looks really small compared to their enterprise customers. Kasi nga tinanong mo kahit sinong office wherever, almost always Microsoft yung isasagot nila sa'yo. Microsoft Office yung gamit nila.
Yeah, regardless of the operating system. Kasi I know a lot of people na naka-Mac sila pero Microsoft Office pa rin yung gamit nila.
Yes, kasi nga talagang, kumbaga it grew up with you. So it's really is a cash cow. So kumbaga, it's been with us since forever. Pero up till now, nag-generate pa rin siya ng very, very good revenues for Microsoft kasi nga subscription na siya. So every single month, somebody somewhere is paying to use that software. It's very interesting actually, pag tinignan mo to, yung chart ng Microsoft. I wanted to, nag-highlight ako dito kasi this was start of 2019. So
yes.
1 year ago, yung price ng Microsoft was about 110, around those numbers. And 1 year later, 179 na siya, almost 180 na. It's crazy.
Yes. Oh.
I don't know kung saan ka makakita ng ganyan kagandang sunod-sunod na ano rin na stock chart, but it's very very nice actually. So and kumbaga nakita mo yung ganitong chart, but also alam mo rin yung mga fundamentals niya, kumbaga kung saan ba talaga nanggagaling yung pera ni Microsoft. So that's always a very very good thing to bear in mind as well.
Yes.
And finally, obviously, we cannot talk about eToro without talking about copy trading, kasi basically copy trading is in our DNA. If there's one thing that people know about eToro, multi-asset stocks, all of these, yung unang-unang parati na lang naisip si Steve and Dave, copy trading, all of these things. So we can't talk about eToro without talking about copy trading. So sa copy trading, why I wanted to highlight it is basically because, again, volatile yung markets ngayon. Coronavirus, Tesla, kung naniniwala ka na akit siya, bababa, making very, very big moves, very, very volatile. It may not be the best for new investors. For example, baka bago ka lang, hindi mo alam ginagawa mo, pumasok ka ng Tesla, may mangyari sa'yo, you might get burned. So if you're a new investor, pwede kang pumasok sa copy trading wherein mangongopya ka ng ibang tao, and then whatever trades na gagawin nila, automatic na gagawin mo rin yun sa inyong account. So, for example, if I copy, let's say, if si Fitz kinopya niya ako, although you can't copy me, I'm an employee of eToro. For example, Fitz, kung kinopya mo ako and bumili ako ng Tesla stock right now, bibilihin mo na rin si Tesla at the moment as well. Sabay tayong bibili. Pag binenta ko na si Tesla, sabay mo rin siyang ibebenta. Parang ganun.
Yes. Actually, on my case, I actually do copy trading because I don't have time to really monitor the markets. What I do is, titingnan ko ano ba yung mga stock na magandang bilhin. Yeah, and as you've shown us na Microsoft and Amazon and other tech companies and mga software companies, they have a good potential to grow. Now, instead of me buying directly these stocks, ang gagawin ko, titingnan ko yung mga top traders sa eToro, titingnan ko kung sino sa kanila yung na bumibili or nagtitrade ng mga tech and software companies, right, or primarily mga nagtitrade ng US equities, and sila yung kinakopy ko. So, ano siya? Hitting two birds with one stone, I have the potential to earn from the movements of the US stock market. Plus, I also protect myself against big losses because I'm actually copying the exact
moves
of a professional trader and investor, no? So, I don't have to worry about opening my account and then seeing na ubos na yung pera ko. I don't think yes, that would happen.
Correct.
So, yun, no? That's why I really love copy trading. And if they can find my profile sa eToro, makikita nyo, my portfolio is composed of people whom I copy, no? Mm-hmm. Yun. So, that's what I actually also show that to some of my friends na yung kinokopya ko, and yun nga, ano, I don't have to do analysis anymore. I let this trade professional these experts do the thinking for me. Basta ako, I just monitor my account. Kung satisfied na ako sa profit ko, I close the position, and then parang ano ko na, binabank ko na,
kinakashin
ko na,
yes,
and then I recopy the person, di ba? So at least na cash out ko na yung kinita ko, tapos ibabalik ulit sa kanya kasi wala namang bayad to copy a person, di ba? You can copy and stop copying
anytime
and as much as you want kasi there are no fees naman for copying a person. Yeah, but of course, when you copy someone and that person opens a position,
may spread, yes.
Yeah, may spread na yon, which is again happens automatically. You don't have to really monitor it and just sit back and watch.
Relax, kumbaga. Not relax, your money grow. Maybe like tama. So yeah, that's actually si Fitz. I'm really enjoying na gusto niyo yung copy trading. Kasi I myself actually it fits a lot of people eh. Kung baguhan ka, wala kang alam, pwede kang mangopya ng traders. Kung alam mong ginagawa mo, that even better. Kasi pwede mo rin i-vet kumbaga yung ano eh, yung ginagawa ng trader na kinokopya mo eh. Pero even if, for example, let's say you're a stock trader, kung ako stock trader ako, wala akong alam sa Forex, for example, pwede ako mangopya na lang ng ibang tao na nagtitrade ng Forex. So ako, I can continue on my stocks. Let's say I want to trade Microsoft, Amazon. I can continue to do that. And at the same time, part of my money lumalaki rin sa Forex. On the other hand, kung Forex ka naman, wala kang alam sa stocks, pwede kang mangopya ng stock trader. Or kung, again, a lot of things. Kasi meron tayong Bitcoin, cryptocurrencies, meron tayong mga commodities like oil and gold. So makahanap ka ng trader na dun naglalagay ng pera.
Yes,
so ikaw mismo,
yes.
Right? Pwede ka na lang mangopya ng ibang tao. So that's actually one very big thing sa ano sa investing and finance is the term diversification. I think even Fitz, ikaw rin inaano mo rin yung ina-advocate mo rin yung diversification.
Yes, of course.
Oo. Correct. So basically that's copy trading, and as you mentioned also Fitz, copy trading itself is yung service mismo ng copy trading is completely free. When you copy someone, makita mo, let's say $200, yun yung minimum to copy someone. If you copy, let's say, a trader with $200, tapos tinap mo yung copy, let's say nagkamali ka lang, tinap mo yung copy, makita mo na kung, let's say, wala pang nagagalaw, then babalik lang yung $200 sa'yo. Kung may gumalaw lang na konti, baka may mababawasan ka lang na konti, pero hindi siya fee. How eToro makes money is through spreads, as you mentioned nga, Fitz. Spreads basically is the difference between the buy and the sell price. Pwede mo siyang isipin as yung ano, di ba pag nag-ano tayo, bumibili tayo, let's say, ng USD using peso, di ba may
yes,
conversion?
Yes, sa banko, naka-display lagi yung buying price at selling
price. Yes, correct. Yes. So basically, ganun siya. Kumbaga, may patong yung eToro sa presyo ng stock price. So for example, if you search for, let's say, Amazon price in Google, tapos kinompare mo yung presyo niya sa eToro, mas mataas lang ng konti yung sa eToro kasi nga, yun yung spreads natin. So it's not just eToro. Most brokers, I think almost all brokers use this model, spread na model. But the good thing with us is yun lang yung charge namin sa inyo, yung spread lang talaga. And then yung copy trading na service mismo, completely free siya.
Yeah, even opening our account is free. Wala kang binabayarang management fee to maintain your account. Wala ngang ano eh, di ba, minimum deposit, alam mo yun. They can just let their account sit, no? Ako, I don't really do anything much with my account after ko na set yung mga copy trades ko.
Yes, iniiwan lang.
Nakaiwan lang siya, yeah. So, ayun, no? So, thank you, Jeff, for sharing those information. I hope may natutunan kayong bago and sana makatulong yon sa inyong investment and trading plan for the rest of the year, no? And of course, kung hindi pa kayo member ng eToro or hindi pa kayo naka-sign up sa eToro, then we will give you a link. Just check the description of this video and punta kayo dun sa link na yon so that you can open a practice account where you will get $100,000 na virtual money na pwede mong gamitin in real time, no? Hindi siya
parang hindi siya maghihintay mo pa.
Oo, no. So you can actually check out the platform eToro. You can already actually interact with people inside and see how it goes, and then use the practice money para matutunan kung paano maggamitin yung platform, and then eventually siguro after a month or so you can try depositing money sa real money sa account mo, kasi from my experience iba yung behavior mo kapag play money ang ginagamit mo versus
money.
Actual money, no? So use the virtual account to get familiar with the platform, and then try to come up with a simple strategy or try to see ano ba yung magandang method in choosing people that you will copy. Then once you establish that, it's time for you to deposit real money so that you can already start earning real money as well, right? So any final words, Jeff, before we end this video interview with you?
Yes, so just a few final words. If you ever need to contact us, you can reach out to me or a few of my colleagues. Normally, once na gumawa kayo ng account sa amin, you can reach us also to our customer service actually. So feel free to ask. We're very, very approachable. Minsan medyo mabagal lang kung busy kami, especially now with all of these coronavirus things. Maraming mga affected na offices, but feel free to reach out to us. And in terms of funding, by the way, tumatanggap na tayo ngayon ng local online banking. So if you have, let's say, Metrobank, BDO, BPI online, we use DragonPay as our partner. Pwede kayo mag-fund through local online banking. The conversion is automatic from peso. Kahit peso yung pera mo, you don't have to worry about it. And lastly, tulad nga nung sinabi mo, Fitz, feel free to play around the virtual account. Libre nang naman gumawa ng account, and there's no obligation for you to fund your account. Test it out. If you like it, then pwede ka mag-fund. If you don't like it, then wala naman mawawala sa'yo kasi free naman po yung virtual account doon. Yes. So thank you very much for the time also, Fitz. Thanks for sharing your time with me. Hopefully, everybody stays safe in the Philippines. I do want to go back soon as well. Hindi na nga ako makalipad ngayon kasi nag-cancel siya ng flights.
Oh, yeah. Merong mga travel plans. So anyway, again, thank you for joining us, Jeff. And see you guys again sa next video natin. All right?
Thank you for having me.
Bye-bye.